Hello, everybody, and welcome to exercise 3. We are looking at page 19 of the workbook here. We're going to see if we can use the integral tables to evaluate the integral of cosine cubed of 4x dx here. Okay, and in this case, first thing you might notice here is that it's practical to use a u substitution to get this into a form that's going to better match our tables. Okay, so I'm going to choose u to be 4x because that's a function that's inside of the cosine cubed function. Okay, so if we do that, let's see, derivative of 4x is just 4. So du is going to be 4 times dx. And to get the dx by itself, we'll go ahead and divide through by 4. Okay, it's important to remember when you're using tables and you do a substitution like this, you need to complete the substitution. Okay, so we're going to plug that u in. But don't forget that dx, okay? We also need to substitute for that. That's going to become du over 4. And that means that that over 4 is something that we can factor out of our integral. So we've got 1/4 integral of cosine cubed of u du. Okay, and so we're going to go to our table and see if we can find a match for that, cosine cubed of u. Okay, that is... kind of looks like a trig function, so I'm betting that we're going to find our match under trigonometric forms, which is a couple of pages into the table here. Okay, and as you look at that list of formulas, do you see anything that looks like it might match for us? Okay, what about formula 68 here? Okay, notice that that's an exact match. It tells us the integral of cosine cubed of u du looks like this. So all we really need to do is to write down the antiderivative that formula 68 gave us. All right, so let's go back and do that. So we've got a 1/4 out front, and then the table told us that the antiderivative for that looks like 1/3 2 plus cosine squared u times sine of u. Be consistent with my notation plus c, and I'm going to remind you where that came from. Okay, that was formula 68. Okay, and last step is to just go ahead and fill that the u back in. U was 4x, so I'm going to take the 1/4 and 1/3 and multiply those together, and we're going to get 1/12 times 2 plus cosine squared of u, which is 4x. Parentheses, sorry. Okay, so I want to make sure to group things together right here. So let's see, we've got this. Okay, this is a little confusing to look at, so I'm going to use brackets and parentheses. So... times sine of 4x, there we go. Okay, and there's our answer. Just a comment, if you look at my written solutions, I think I went a little bit farther and simplified this down a little bit more by multiplying things out. There's really no reason to do that, though. This answer, as we've written it here, this is good enough. So you can take your pick, either the answer that we have here or the one in my written solutions. Either answer is okay.